Hello, I'm Randy Hill, and welcome to day two of our special video series on solar energy. As we discussed yesterday, solar energy works right now. Many Americans are already using solar panels on their homes. Here is another way it works. One of the highest uses of energy in American households today is a water heater and heat pumps. While Americans are away at work or sleeping at night, the common hot water heater continues to maintain its temperature in order to have hot water always available. Here's how solar can potentially reduce a major amount of what I call maintaining energy consumption. On top of your roof, a solar collector is installed. A solar collector is a sealed glass pane that allows sunlight in, but it prevents a majority of that heat from escaping. Inside the collector is a black metal circulating tube. As the light comes in, the tube gets hot and heats the water inside the tube. That hot water is then sent to an insulated hot water tank, and cool water from the house's water supply then flows into the backside of the circulating tubes to be heated by the sun again. Thus, the hot water is stored and ready for use when the homeowner needs it. A pipe can also be run throughout the home to a radiator in each room. The hot water in the radiator can then be used to heat each room in the winter as heat radiates into the air from the hot water inside the radiator. The only downside to the solar panels is that they aren't cheap, but that's all the more reason why we need federal tax policy to help homeowners make it an important investment. So now we've discussed two ways that solar power can work. Yesterday, creating a current of electricity, and today, heating tubes for radiant heat. Today, we should start thinking about our energy plans for tomorrow. Join me again tomorrow on the blog at rwhill.com.